What is going on, guys? Nefightly doing another video, and welcome back to an episode of Mineko When They Cry. Last time we left off, the servants are absolutely sus as hell. So is Maria, and pretty much so is everybody alive, if we take a look at the characters, not tips. I don't think it's any of these three, but, I mean, this, I pointed this out before, but this definitely means something. And, I mean, the servants were also talking about Beatrice, so that also means something. So, yeah, hopefully we can continue with the mystery, and maybe, who knows, we'll find the culprit, though I doubt it because it's episode one, so we're probably going to get, like, a lot of misdirects. And, like, who knows, what's the culprit be George? Look, Kurosawa, I know I said the servants, but she's definitely the least suspicious servant out of all of them. For the time being, I put aside whether a 19th person existed, and announced their theory that the goal of the culprit might have been to make us solve the riddle of the epitaph. Uncle Hideyoshi seemed to be extremely interested, but not Natsu. He said it was ridiculous and dismissed it.
確かに、そう考えると、あの怪しい手紙も納得がいくっていうもんや。その動機はなかなかええ線を言っとると思うで。マリアちゃんに手紙を渡したのが誰かはさておきな。
No, don't even start there. Even though she's puffing up her cheeks in that cute way she's been doing since yesterday, I couldn't think of it as cute. Yeah, no, she's creepy. If I poked fun at her, it might suddenly transform into a creepy laugh. Wait. Hold up. You're lying. The day before Kraus got killed, he sold you a bar of the hidden gold to prove its existence. Oh, rookie mistake. You are now on the suspect list, Mrs. Natsui.
それを私たちに解かせて横領を企んでいるという動機はなるほどと頷けるものがあります。しかし、ならばなぜ後ろ宮家の主要な人物ばかりを最初に殺したのです。
道理ですな。謎を解かせるなら、金蔵さんに近しい人物を先に殺すことは得策ではないはずです。
Okay, why are you defending that? Killing those closest to Kinzo? I mean, Natsui is still alive. You're still alive. Genji is still alive. He said that everyone else sucked, so... Now I'm sus of him too. Everything and everyone is lying.
その論法で行くんだったら、最初にお父様を脅迫した方が早くない？私たちに謎を解かせるよりも、本人に答えを聞いた方が早いはずよ。
確かにその通りや。もっとも、お父さんが並大抵の脅迫で口を割るとは思えんが。
金蔵さんをよく知る方なら、金蔵さんが並大抵の脅しには
屈しないことをよく存じているでしょう。Second Twilight, tips. In the second Twilight, those who remain shall tear apart the two who are close. Okay, but who's close? I get it. It's probably these two. Unless someone else is close, though. Kenan kind of respected Genji, but I wouldn't say they were necessarily... Yeah, no, it's probably gonna be them.
これだけの財産を持つ
後ろ宮家
を背負われる方です。
Wait, it could be Natsui and Jessica.
今日まで、
I think it's gonna be Natsui and Jessica who are gonna die. Oh my god, I like Jessica. Natsui's okay. I like her story, but I mean, she literally just lied in front of everyone.
それに関しては私もどう、うちのじい様が脅されて何かに従うなんて、ちょっと想像もつかないぜ。
ジェシカ、言葉遣いがはしたないです。
Oh my, now is not the time.
はい。
なら、こういう発想はどうだろう。いや、これもぶっ飛んでるか。
A way out. I couldn't hesitate. Out there, ideas are like bows and arrows. It might be hard to hit with, but it's a great weapon because you can hit enemies far away. They say most people who have died in battle were killed by arrow wounds. In a battle, you can't just shoot off one arrow. You shoot off a whole bunch of arrows at once, pushing forwards towards the enemy troops with a wall of them. So keep shooting over and over. Create walls as you push forward towards the truth.
犯人が隠された黄金が狙いってんなら、俺たちに解かせるのは効率が悪い。謎を作った本人に答えを聞く方が手っ取り早いさ。
Ah, yes, he's flipping the chessboard around again.
じゃあさ、
It just fits better.
これ全て、爺様に宛てたメッセージってことじゃないのか。
In other words, these murders were a threat made against Grandfather. If he didn't tell the culprit where the gold was, his family members would be killed off one by one. What if we weren't the only ones being forced to solve this riddle? What if Grandfather was too? Think about it that way, it explains Grandfather's mysterious disappearance. If the culprit has already attacked Grandfather, then judging by the state of the six corpses, were left in, he should have been left on display somewhere with that horrible makeup added. But despite that, we still haven't found him.So does that mean Grandfather has been kidnapped and is being held somewhere?
Sonna, masaka, sonna.
Omoshiroi hanashi janai?
I kind of like. I'm starting to like Eva a little better because she's agreeing with Daru's logic, which is definitely more on track than Natsui's logic. Like, Natsui thinks there's someone in the woods killing everyone.
次々に殺人を繰り返すぞ。と脅されているわけ。
その話のどこが面白いのか理解に苦しみます。
Because it's a good theory. Unnaturally glared at her, but Aunt Eva just smiled calmly.
この時間になっても姿を現さない以上、おじい様が事件に巻き込まれているのはほぼ間違いないと思います。それを思えば、バトラ君の仮説も無視することはできないんじゃないですか。
ジョージは黙ってなさい。
No, don't
そもそもお父様ってい
ついなくなったのかしら。For once, he's making sense. Actually, no, he always is the first.
最後にお父さんの姿を見たのは誰や？
多分私でしょう。
Oh yeah, it was.
今朝主人たちの姿が見えないと騒ぎになった時。
Yeah, but wait, no, you couldn't have done anything because Eva was outside.
私がお部屋にお伺いしてそこでご挨拶をしました。そういえば、書斎の鍵をずっと借りっぱなしですね。
Why would you tell them this?
これは返しておきます。
Unnaturally put out the golden key and handed. Why are you giving the probable culprit the key? Looking at the key, Aunt Eva giggled.
ねえ、源氏さん、どうせ警察はお父様の部屋も徹底的に捜査すると思うわ。何を隠していてもどうせ暴かれちゃう。だったらちょっと早く今この場で話してくれてもいいんじゃないかしら。
何のお話でしょうか。
シンプルな話よ。お父様の書斎はその鍵がなければ外から入ることはできない密室よ。
Yeah, that is true.
その定義の確認をしたいの。お父様の部屋には入り口が一つある。
I flipped the chessboard. I know that's not how the saying is supposed to apply, but on Eva, and now I kind of like her because it's no longer doesn't seem like it's about like the money now. It now seems like was it good detective points?
あとは他に出入り口は？
ありません。中に入るには入り口しかありません。
What about the if you climb out the window?
秘密の隠し扉なんかがあったりはしないのね。お父様が不在である以上、後ろ宮家の最高序列者は私よ。その後ろ宮家の当主代行として聞いているの。それを理解した上で答えなさい。あの部屋には入り口以外に他に出入り口は？お父様の最高の側近だったあなたは知っているはずよ。
Aunt Natsuo looked a little offended at the pert about the highest ranked family member, but she kept her mouth closed for the time being and waited for Genji's answer. I couldn't help but feel a little uncomfortable.Why was he going on and on about hidden doors?
カノン君も熊沢さんも知ってるなら教えてくれない？あるならあるって言ってくれた方がいいの。
Honestly, this visual novel is a roller coaster right now. Like, my opinions on all the characters have just, like, changed a lot.
じゃないと今からある人がとても追い詰められることになるわよ。隠し扉があると仮定されたら、私の話はすべて水の泡。
Aunt Eva didn't specify which person was about to be driven into a corner, but following the flow of the conversation, I had a feel that she was referring to Aunt Natsui.
母さん、 何の話？
ジョージは少し黙ってなさい。どうなの？
Don't make me hate you again. I just don't like you.
カノン君、そして熊沢さん、隠し扉はあるの？ないの？ゲンジさんはお父様が書斎を改造したとき、施工業者の監督をしていたはず。
Wait, why would he oversee? That's sort of weird.
知らないとは言わせないわよ。
そのようなものは親方様の書斎にはありません。
間違いなく片翼のわしを許されたカノン君。
はい、間違いなく親方様の書斎に隠し扉などありません。
I really think that they're lying about it.
熊沢さんは？
いえ、私も聞いたことがありませんよ。
Wait, is he even allowed to? With the eagle, let me check his spirit real quick. She doesn't have the eagle. Ah! Okay, so...I think that clears her of lying in this case.
お父様と親交の深い南條先生は？
私もそんなものは聞いたことがありませんな。
結構。じゃあいい？
Okay.
話を始めるわよ。
So, he also could be lying because he's been in there the most. But the thing is, if I'm talking about, oh, because he doesn't have the crust, he can't be lying, well...Yeah, just as I thought, he doesn't have it either, so... My argument kind of falls apart there, but... You'd think that Kumasawa would have it because he's a servant, as opposed to just some guy who's here. So, I'm still sticking by that.
とっても simple な話なの。
Everyone tilted their heads, doubtfully wondering what Aunt Eva was starting to talk about so proudly.Aunt Eva laughed triumphantly as though she were about to reveal a secret only she knew.
お父様を最後に目撃したのは、
okay.
夏日姉さんよね。詳しい時間は忘れちゃったけど、今朝の9時前くらいのことだと思ったわ。姉さん、覚えてる？私、あなたがお父様の書斎からちょうど出てくるところに出くわした。
覚えています。それが何だというのですか？
そして、次に姉さんがお父様の書斎を訪れたのは、兄さんたちの遺体が見つかってからよね。それを報告しに書斎に上がり、そこで私と一緒に不在を確認したわ。ところで姉さん、その時お父様の書斎に入ろうとして気づいたことはなかったかしら？
気づいたこと？何のことですか？
You really shouldn't be pissing off the person with the gun, Eva. She still has that, at least I think she does.
ほーら、ゴミを拾ったでしょう。畳んだレシートを。
This is the first time I'm hearing about this.
そんなゴミを拾った気がします。それが何か？
そのレシートは私が飛行場に着く前に寄った売店で飴玉を買った時にもらったものよ。
Aunt Eva pulled a small bag of candy out of her handbag.
ああ、あの時に買った飴のレシート。でも母さん、そのレシートの話が何と関係あるの？
ジョージ、もうちょい黙って聞いとって。
Oh my! You're ruining your likability. Stop this!Uncle Hideyoshi's expression was a little strict. Apparently, he understood what Aunt Eva was getting at.
本当にこれは気まぐれよ。何かを予見してたとか。ましてや夏日姉さんを罠にかけようとか。そう、実はね、そのレシート。姉さんがお父様と最後に会って出てきて、そこで私と会ったでしょ。その時、書斎の扉に私が挟み込んだものなのよ。
ってことは。どういうことですか？つまり夏日おばさんがそのレシートを拾うまで誰もと…
ちょっと待ってよ、エヴァおばさん。レシート挟むなんてバレバレだって。じいさまが外出した時に気づいて面白がってもう一回挟み直した可能性も。
ジェシカ hurriedly argued back. She still didn't really know what this all meant, but she realized that whatever it was, Oh my god, you have a million IQ.
バレないようにレシートは小さく折りたたんだわ。でもね、レシートが落ちるところを仮に見たとしても、扉のどこの高さの部分に挟み、私は夏日姉さんが鍵を取り出している間に確認したわ。レシートが挟み込まれた位置は寸分の1ミリの違いもなく私が挟んだ場所だった。なぜそんな子供じみたいたずらをされるのか。大方、私の部屋の扉にいたずらをしたのもあなたでしょう。
Oh
yeah, there was blood on it.
不愉快な話だったので話しませんでしたが、今朝目が覚めたら扉の外側にあのシャッターの落書きと同じと思われる赤い塗料でいたずらがされていたのです。かきむしったような気持ちの悪い跡で。
何やその話。なんで今まで黙っとったんや。
申し訳ありません。あの後立て続けにいろいろと恐ろしいことが起こったため。
Yeah, that's right. And her reaction was like not fake.
知らないわよそんなの。私がしてるのは姉さんの部屋じゃなくてお父様の部屋の扉の話よ。
姉さんがお父様がいるのを確認してから、私と一緒に不在を確認するまでの間、扉を使わず。どうやってお父様は外に出たのかしら。
Simple. Someone could have climbed the wall and entered through the window. Or it could have been Beatrice. It was reverse Romeo and Juliet.
そんなことは知りません。私が知りたいくらいです。
夏日姉さんの他にお父さんの在室を確認したのは誰や。
昨夜金蔵さんとチェスをしたのは会った最後ですな。夕食の直前までご一緒だったはずです。
それより後の時間は誰かおらんのか。
私です。昨夜の晩餐のお世話をしております。
はい、僕とシャノンも一緒でした。
はあ、はあ、 Was this before the guest house shift? Because that is impossible if...
ここまでは間違いなくお父さんも部屋にいたやろな。
When last night? If they did that when, like, after Sandin and George proposed, then they're the culprits.
だがな、夏日姉さん、不在だった書斎は窓も扉も全て閉め切られた状態だったそうやないか。なのに夏日さんは今朝お父さんに会って話をしたいと。
私には皆さんが何を険悪になったのか、どなたか説明してくださいますかな。
父さんと母さんは、夏日おばさんが今朝おじい様に会ったというのは嘘だと言っているのかい。
嘘なんかつくもんかよ。母さんは潔白だぜ。なんで嘘なんかつくんだよ。
ジェシカ、言葉遣いを直しなさいといつも言っています。
Are you kidding me? All at once the whole room was in an uproar. Aunt Eva and Aunt Natsui confronted each other across the poker table, which was confronting Jessica. What the heck's going on?
複数の人間の目撃があるのは、でも今朝以降お父様の姿を見たと称するのは夏日姉さんただ一人。そして私の挟んだレシートが物語る奇妙な事実。
Wait. Oh wait, never mind. Sorry, I was just thinking in my head. When did you put the receipt in?
この点と点はどうやれば結べるのかしら。
Aunt Eva urged everyone to imagine it, so that receipt could become an important point. But I didn't know which other points to tie it to or how. Try searching for the answer Aunt Eva probably wants.We'll find that Aunt Natsui lied and acted as though grandfather was in this room this morning. Has that fact been exposed by a whim of Aunt Eva's?
わけわかんねえぜ。なんで母さんが嘘をつかなきゃならないんだよ。その理由はねえじゃねえかよ。
その理由は私も知りたいわよ。でもね、ジェシカちゃん、お父様の材質を偽る価値が全くないとは限らないのよ。推理小説でもたまに出てくるでしょ。
生存時刻を偽ることによって自分のアリバイを偽証するトリックよ。
So it's in Jessica like the two who have had the least amount of conflict out of anyone. Don't make them fight each other.
なんだそりゃ、そんなの聞いたことないぜ。
お父様はまだ見つからないけれど、普通に考えればもう殺されていると考えるのが自然でしょうね。となれば必ず近いうちに死体は見つかる。
I do agree with that.
その時、
Oh my god, Eva, stop making such good points. I really want to agree with Jessica here.
夏日姉さんはアリバイを作ることができるの。わかる？みんな？
It's not... Oh my... So much drama! I'm trying to think... Okay, so, I definitely think that Aunt Nat- Why do I keep saying Aunt? Because it says so right in front of me. What the f- Oh my god, okay. Calm down. Think about this. Step at a time. Natsui... I... really looks like she did it, but I really don't think she did it. And then she moved the body to some other location and tampered with it. That's... I really don't think that it was her. But I kind of can't really refute that. Crap. Then she could say, I heard someone screaming. Dash over there and become the first to find the body along with everyone else. Is that what... I mean, that kind of reminds me of the third case of Danganronpa 1. She's making it really hard to side with her, so I guess I won't.
そうだぜ。死亡時刻を少しくらいごまかしたって、そんなの警察が検視すりゃ一発でバレるじゃねえかよ。古典の世界だったらともかく、現代日本でそんなトリック本気で通用すると思ってんのかよ。おかしいぜ。
そうかしら。今朝南條先生が亡くなった人たちの死体を見て、死亡時刻を曖昧に見積もられたわよ。検視結果は環境や個体差に非常に左右されやすい。
I forget. He said he couldn't do anything with the bodies.
数時間単位で誤差の出る非常にアバウトなものなのよ。
Oh my god, where's my truth bullets?
しかも困ったことに、警察の科学的な捜査は明日にならないとできない。そこまでの正確な死亡時刻を測ることなんて、ジェシカちゃんの言う現代日本でもそうそう簡単ねえ。南條先生、
検視は経験と勘の必要な非常に難しい作業です。誤信率も非常に高いと聞いております。確かにほんの数時間程度の誤差を出してしまうことは大いにあり得るでしょうな。
しかしアリバイの世界は数時間もあれば十分やで。古典のトリックとちゃう、十分に通用するトリックなんや。夏日姉さん、わしらあんたを疑いたいわけやない
で。 Yes, you do.
疑いとうないから潔白を示してほしいだけなんや。
Oh, she picked it up. She picked it up. She picked it up.
今朝私は確かにお父様にお会いしました。
Oh my God, drop the gun.
肩行くのわしを刻めとお言葉をいただいて。
Oh my God, everything is falling apart. The last two episodes have been calm and scary mysteries.
それだけは断じて許せません。お父様がかけられた言葉までも否定することは断じて許せ。
あるいは。お父様の遺体は出てこないのかしら。普通失踪は死亡宣告に7年かかるもの。余命残りわずかなお父様を7年も延命し、その財産を独占するにはなんと。
聞きつ
けなりません。 Oh my god. Holy. This is not going good.
私は後ろ見や夏日、この身に堅欲のわしをまとう資格はなくとも、胸の中に鹿と刻まれています。当初跡継ぎのクラウスの妻として、その責務を代行する私に向かって何たる暴言。
何、その銃で私を撃つの。いいわよ、撃っちゃえば。どうせいいのなら
they're both fucking out of their minds. Yeah, no, Eva just ruined your like ability and I really want to believe Natsui. The story's been so sad so far, but like, she clearly lied already. It wasn't like Aunt Natsui had been actually holding the gun at the ready and threatening anyone. But as she was egged on by Aunt Eva, she did hold it at the ready. Unsurprisingly, once things got to the States, Jessica and Genji-san tried to stop her. She already did! What more do you want from this woman? I feel so bad for her. Even though she was the culprit, she's kind of failing to cover this up.
だから説明してほしいのよ。お父様がどうやって部屋からいなくなったのか。窓は内側からしっかり閉じられていた。扉も同じよ。
No, that's wrong.
今朝夏日姉さんが
間違いなくお父様があった。夏日姉さんが間違いなくお父様があった。夏日姉さんが
開かぬ扉の密室からいかにしてお父様が部屋からいなくなったかをじゃないと。姉さんが嘘つきってことにやっぱりなっちゃうものね。
あなたという人
反論したいならぜひしなさいな。そうね、今すぐこの場で釈明をしてみなさい。そうしたらあなたを疑ったことを謝ってあげてもいいわ。あの書斎の密室からお父様はいかにして抜け出したのか。
そんなこと説明もできませんし不要です。
そうなら私が説明してあげる。私の立場も姉さんの立場もいいとこ取りのとても仲良しな説明なんだ。姉さんの言う今朝の時点でお父様が在室していたことを信じてあげるわよ。でも次に扉が開かれた時にお父様はいなかった。
He could have used the window. I mean, the lock opens from the insideThe way, how could he have locked that? This is a perfect locked room clock crime right here.
その軽薄な口を慎みなさい。
私の推理はこうよ。扉から姉さんしか出入りしていないことは私が2回確認している。そしてレシートもそれを立証しているにもかかわらずお父様を部屋から出すパズルの答えは窓よ。窓から出したのよ。夏姫さんはお父様を3階の書斎の窓から中庭に突き落としたね。
Then there would be a body in the courtyard.
おどれ
奥様、こらえてください。
エヴァ様、どうかおやめくださいませ。
その後中庭に転落して死んだお父様の遺体は夏日姉さんが屋敷内の戸締まりを確認すると言って出て行った時にどこかへ隠した
の。その時
に死亡時刻を偽り考察もしたんでしょうね。
Oh my god, I still hate agreeing with her.
クラウス兄さんたちの事件もさらに昨日のビアトリーチェの事件も
It couldn't be Natsu. She didn't even know about the gold until Kraus showed. It's the servants, not her.
なぜこの私が
後ろ宮夏日がこのような恥ずかしい。
She doesn't do good under stress. Oh. Looks like we've got everyone's views on record now.
ダメだな。全然ダメだぜ。エヴァおばさん。
ダメって何がだよ、バトラ。
Jessica looked up at me, hanging on to my every word. Ani's expression was confident as ever.
全然ダメって何が？バトラ君、聞かせてよ。
一方からしか見られないから、夏日おばさんしかありえないって思い込んじまうのさ。
But if we flip the chessboard,
夏日おばさんを擁護するわけじゃねえが、
Oh my god, he's talking about chess again.
通用しねえ。レシートを軸にした推理はまずまずだとは思う。筋は悪くない。だが、俺の採点じゃせいぜい65点ってとこだ。これが答案なら、居残りで補習ってとこだぜ。
あら、じゃあレシートで封印されている扉をどうやって破ってお父様を失踪させられるというの？私の説。
エヴァおばさんの説は確かに面白い。そして、その説以外に、じい様が失踪できる方法がないって言い切れるなら、最終目撃者である夏日おばさんが黒であると確かに言い切れるだろう。だが、夏日おばさんが無実で濡れ衣である可能性が残っている以上、そうだとた。
ならバトラ君は夏日姉さん以外の誰にお父様を失踪させられたというの？姉さんしかありえないのよ。私のレシートがそれを証明してしまったわ。一度目に書斎に訪れた夏日姉さん、そして二度目に私と訪れるまでの間、書斎は完全に密室で、密室開封後には失踪している。これで夏日姉さんが犯人じゃないというなら、どんなトリックがあるっていうの？
だから65点なんだよ、エヴァおばさん。
Explain why。Oh my... Yes! Spin the chessboard! Spin the chessboard around!
どうやって外部からじい様を失踪させるかじゃない、どうやって内部からじい様が失踪するかって考えるんだ。扉にはレシートが挟まれていたから使用されていない。
窓も
出ることはできても外側からは施錠できず、しかもエヴァおばさんは書斎を訪れた時に窓の中から窓も使用されていない。その時点では確かに書斎は密室だった。これは認めるしかない。だがしかし、書斎は永遠に密室だったわけじゃない。レシートの封印さえ解かれれば、扉は使用可能になり脱出可能になる。
Oh yeah, what if he was in hiding?
つまり夏日おばさんがどうやってじい様を失踪させたかじゃない、どうやってじい様は書斎を脱出したのかって考えるんだよ。じい様の書斎はただの書斎じゃねえんだよな。源氏さんの話じゃ、トイレからキッチン、ベッドルームまであるちょいとした家並みじゃねえか。例えばベッドの下にでも潜って隠れたら、
I'm assuming they probably know that things like that。
そこまで調べてきたわけじゃねえだろ。そしておばさんたちは失踪したと思い会館へ戻る。
That's...
この時レシートはもうない。
Good job, battler。
つまりじいさんは密室である
間に部屋に隠れ続け、 picking sides in this murder mystery. I'm just picking sides。
エヴァおばさんたちをやり過ごした後に部屋から脱出することでこの密室を破ることができる。
何よそれ、どうしてお父様がそんな妙なことをして部屋を抜け出さなきゃならないの？口頭無形にも程があるわよ。
ああ、口頭無形かもな。だがそれでも夏日おばさんが濡れ衣かもしれない可能性は示してる。エヴァおばさんのレシートは完璧じゃねえ。チェスで言えばチェックくらいにはなった。だがチェックメイトじゃねえ。そして俺が最高に気に入らねえのは、それを夏日おばさんに釈明しろと迫って、それがまかり通るってんなら、ここでもう一回チェス盤をひっくり返させてもらおうじゃねえか。
He did the Phoenix Wright pose。
エヴァおばさん、あんたの論法によるならよ、あんたと秀吉おじさんが昨日親父たち6人を殺害してからのこのことゲストハウスに帰ったんじゃないってことを、この場夏日おばさんに釈明を敷いたんだ。あんたにはもちろん、じい様の遺産が全部転がり込むエヴァおばさんよ。
そうだぜ、エヴァおばさんだって十分怪しいじゃ
ねえかよ。母さん
がじい様の最終目撃者だから怪しいって言うなら、エヴァおばさんだって父さんたちの最終目撃者じゃないか。バトラの言う通りだぜ、自分たちは殺してないってことを証明してみせろよ。
僕もお母さんの推理は、しかしレシートの件は確かに重要なヒントだと思う。でもそれはバトラ君の言う通り、 夏日おばさんが何がしかの犯人であることを断定できるものじゃない。僕たちは等しく夏日おばさんだけが責められる道理はない。
誇り高きお父様が床に這いつくばってベッドのそんな誰事で
説明つくと思って。 He could have hid elsewhere too. He might be in the refrigerator.
それならエヴァおばさんが先に説得人を誰がどうやって殺してそして自分が関わっていないという証拠を示してみろってんだ。
What? Why is she dying? What the hell? What the hell?
お嬢様、お嬢様。
Jessica suddenly started coughing. At first, I thought she was choking after yelling too loud, but before long, I realized how painful it looked. Jessica kept coughing and choking down on her hand. What's happening?
ジェシカ、しっかり。ナンジャ先生。
ジェシカさん、吸入器を早く。
Oh, wait, wasn't that in her character bio? She's born with weak bronchi and sometimes associated with... Yeah! Okay, that explains that. Cool. I thought that sounded familiar.
私は持ってきているのがあります。
Dr. Nanja pulled a...bronchoalinator inhaler from his own bag, which was lying on the sofa, and handed it to Jessica. Come to think of it, 6 years ago, didn't Jessica sometimes break into violent coughing fits and have to use that? However, 6 years ago, I never saw Jessica look like she was in this much pain.
Oh, 兄貴, Jessica ってこんなに喘息ひどかったっけ?ここ数年でだいぶ悪くなったんだよ。大丈夫な時はいいんだけどね。突然発作が来ると咳が止まらなくなるんだよ。
お嬢様、お薬です。さ、
taking the inhaler from Cannon-kun, Jessica used it with a practiced hand. It looked like her throat would still itch for a while, but she had it under control.
大丈夫かよ、ジェシカ。びっくりしたぜ。
大したことねえよ。心配すんじゃねえぜ。
Beads of sweat covered Jessica's whole body, and she couldn't hide her rough breathing, but it looked like her sudden attack had calmed down for now. I like how that's what made everyone stop arguing. This disturbance had made the dangerous atmosphere up until now seem slowly unfocused, but that's fine. That kind of battle of mutual suspicion is completely unnecessary. When we think about it, finding alibis of each other and looking for the culprit is probably meaningless. After all, we're just powerless, ordinary people.And when the police come tomorrow, they'll definitely employ cutting-edge techniques and investigate the case thoroughly. Solving all the riddles and arresting the culprit.
確かにバトラ君の言う通りかしら。夏日姉さんが疑わしいように、私たちも疑わしさを拭えていな。それを今議論し合うのは確かに不毛ね。
That would have gone worse if Battery didn't do anything. Probably would have ended with Natsui shooting her.
でも、バトラ君だって知りたいんじゃないの?犯人を。大切な人を失った痛みを思い知らせてやるために、一秒でも早く知りたいんじゃない?
それは否定しないです。これだけの上等を決めてくれやがった野郎を。た、でも。だからといって、18人の中の誰かを疑いたくはない。さっきはああ言ったが、俺は、エヴァおばさんだって疑いたくない。俺にとってのエヴァおばさんは、ちゃめっ気があって、いつも楽しい。そんなおばさんと、こんな罵り合いはしたくねえ。ここにいる誰だって、そんなことは望んでねえはずさ。だろ、みんな。
バトラ君に同じ、意味のない罵り合いだね。多分、これだけの人数が、朝から一ところにずっと集まってるから。
でしょうな。無理もないことです。言ってできるものではありませんが、なるべく皆さんリラックスしましょう。
Just like that, everything was back to normal, even though everyone just was so worked up.
わしらも頭を冷やすべきとちゃうか。レシートの件は確かにお父さんの失踪を探る上で重要な手がかりになると思う。警察が来たら話すといいやろ。
そうね、そう。レシートの一件でつい鬼の首を取ったような気持ちになっちゃったのね。確かに夏日姉さんだけを疑うのはフェアじゃないわ。
Oh my...
私たちだって等しく疑わしい。
Yeah.
でもね、バトラ君、レシートの話だけは本当よ。
It's nice. Everyone's getting
along again. そしてこれがどういう意味を持つか、もう一度よく。
Aniva and Uncle Hideyoshi stood up. Okay, they pointed out leaving the parlor.
結局私たちはこんな推理ごっこしても意味はないのよ。だってどうせ警察が全て明かしてくれるんですもの。
That's right. Even if we don't play this detective game, the typhoon will pass. And when those alive we see goes return to the harbor, everything will settle itself. That's right. If you think about this, the kind of crime is completely trivial. It will definitely be resolved. Even if we do nothing.When the seagulls cry, they said the name of the game.
これ以上、夏日姉さんも私の顔を見ていたくはないでしょ。私も同じよ。確か姉さんは昨日ゲストハウスに帰らなくて済むようにって客室を用意してくれたのよね。あそこはバスもトイレもあるし、鍵もチェーンもかかる。横になれるベッドもあるし。主人もマリアちゃんとチャンネル争いをせずにテレビを見ることができるわ。お好きになさるといいね。
Oh, she picked up the gun again.
くれぐれも用心を。ありがとう、姉さん。そして余計なお世話よ。姉さんはみんなの監視をよろしくね。犯人はこの中に必ずいるんだから。そして姉さんも自分が監視をされていることをお忘れなく。捨てゼリフはそれで十分ですか。十分よ。じゃあね、夏日姉さん、源氏さん、夕食になったら呼んでね。それまでチェーンをかけて閉じ込めて。
Eva's such an interesting character.
源氏、カノ、お二人を客室までお送りを。結構よ。送り狼なんて言え。むしろ、私たちが部屋に行くまで誰も来ない。ジョージ行くわよ。
僕はここでみんなといるよ。
ジョージ、この部屋に犯人がいる。そんなところにいるつもり。
この部屋を出るということは親族の誰かを疑うのと同じことだ。僕はあんな恐ろしいことができる人間が親族にいるなんて信じない。
Oh my god, remember when I said that he was the, my least favorite of the cousins? Yeah, no, that's not true anymore.
ジョージ、あなたからも言ってやってよ。
ジョージももう一人前の。そのジョージの仁義がこの部屋から出えへん言わせるなら、そ好きにさせたれ。
父さん。
Aniva and Uncle Hideyoshi left. The only voice that called after them was the sound of the rain. Assuming Natsui is really thankful at the moment.The pearl was being buried beneath the savage atmosphere. When I looked at the clock, I was surprised to find that it was already evening. Have we really spent that much time worrying about needless things, talking with each other, fighting with each other? Feeling bored, I started scratching at my head when Maria and I made eye contact. I was a little surprised since I thought she was completely immersed in the TV.
今なら信じるぜ。
ほう。
手紙も殺人もすべて。ベアトリーチェの仕業。いや。むしろ頼むからそうだと名乗り出てほしいぜ。19人目の仕業ってことにさせてくれ。じゃなきゃ俺たち18人はいつまでもた。これなら19人目の存在を信じる方がマシさ。扉も窓も開けずに爺様を外へ連れ出すなんて、ベアトリーチェならお茶の子さいさいなんだろう。
マリア、after taking a single short breath, hung her head and then raised her face again.
そうだよ。魔女の前に扉の鍵なんて何の役にも立たないんだよ。ベアトリーチェは72中の全てに精通する。33位のガープは望む相手を望む場所へ瞬時に運ぶ力を与えるし、彼女にとってどのような密室に閉じこもった人間だろうと連れ。
魔女はすげえな。頼むから、もしまだ事件を起こす気なら絶対俺に19人目を。いや、
魔女の存在を信じさせてくれ
よ。 No, don't give up, Battler.
いいよ。あったら伝えておくよ。
Ah, now something bad's gonna happen. Yep, crap. Nothing's made sense for a while now. Just when I want to believe a 19 person, I deny it. And just when I want to believe there are only 18 people, I deny that too. Even though I want there to be more than just 18 people here, I can't accept the existence of a 19th person. In short, even though there are more than 18 people, there are less than 19 people. The number of people in this mansion is 19x18. So you're forgetting the equal to part of the greater than in, or equal to, and less than or equal to. No, it's just greater than. Ah. However, it's impossible for there to be anything after the decimal point. You should be able to show the number of people with anything but an integer. And yet, 19 is greater than x, which is greater than 18. How do you explain that fraction less than 1? It's no wonder that a 19th person was something that couldn't be seen. And that's why, since you can only write the number of people as an integer, you couldn't see that person. That which cannot be seen. Because Beatrice has no body, therefore she is invisible. Is there a 19th person or not? Does a witch exist or not? 19x18. The witch exists somewhere in that x. Yep, knew that was coming. I always do it. Took me by surprise at first. What time is it? Okay. We're making it around the clock. 7. Watch me read that wrong. Well, watch that be wrong. Because I kind of already read it. The uncomfortable atmosphere continued even after those two left. It was thick with the idea that simply thinking about the culprit's identity would be the same as deciding whom to suspect. It had begun to feel like discussion of the case was itself taboo. So no one mentioned the case, at least out loud. However, those thoughts that were filled our minds. All that we could say out loud made our heads feel like they were going to explode. So, at least on the outside, the purr had once again regained its calm mood. Everything was left unsettled.
少しだけ雨足が弱まった気がするね。
おお、まだいっぱい降ってる。おお。
仮に止んだって、この島には船がねえんだし。船が明日すぐに来てくれりゃいいんだがよ。洋館バカンさんもお腹いっぱいだぜ。
母さん、明日船はいつ来るのかな。
本来なら帰りの船は今日の3時に来てくれることになっています。先方も台風が過ぎてから来直すと電話をしてくれたでしょうが、あいにく電話は普通ですから。でも向こうも子供の使いではありません。客人の方々の送迎目的だと教えてありますから、おそらく明日の朝一番
で、 unless they're involved in it and we're specifically told not to come、
9時頃くらいに来てくれるでしょう。
It was completely black outside. When I looked at the clock, I realized that it was just past 7. I was starting to get hungry. Okay, good, I didn't read that wrong. I know this is such a dumb thing, but in the kitchen, Kurosawa was cooking enthusiastically. She had laid out a variety of dishes, and while they didn't match the level of Goda's artful cooking, they were still gorgeous. It was an act of kindness from Kurosawa, who was trying to envy in everyone's low spirits with some food. Kurosawa wasn't nearly as talented as a professional cook like Goda, but she was far from unskilled. On the contrary, she had been brought up in a fishing village to the simply... What a weird time for a little bit of a backstory. Kanan arranged the food Kurosawa had finished creating on plates under her direction. Kanan also helped in the kitchen sometimes, but since he was rarely placed in that role, he was slightly awkward, even though he tried his best. Self-conscious about the fact that he couldn't clearly arrange the food, Kanan's expression darkened slightly. But Kurosawa smiled as though everything was fine.
きれいに盛り付けられてますよ。カノン君もお上手ですよ。
シャノン姉さんだったらもっときれいに。
Kanan stopped arranging the food for a bit and hung his head. Sen was the only one who assisted Kurosawa in her cooking. Tonight, Kanan was doing it instead. And as he remembered Sen's face in her brutal end, he grimaced.
今は忘れなさい。
Genji spoke kindly to Kanan as he advanced the pawn. Advanced the pawn? What is happening?
今は。
それがいいだろう。
あ、 Oh, I read that wrong for a second. Kenji purposely refrained from facing Ken as he spoke. He did so because he understood that it might make things tougher on Kenan if he noticed that someone was looking at his eyes. Nance also understood that and held back by any thoughtless words.
Kinzo-san mo doko e ikaretan desu? Go buji da to ii no desu ga. Wakarimasen. Tada, subete wa oyakata-sama ga nozomare. Sore o jasui suru koto wa...親方様にお仕えする家具には過ぎたことです。源氏さんは怖くないので、私には今夜まだ何か良くないことが起こるような気が。怖いことなど私はただ後ろ宮家にお仕えするだけですので。
Nanzo sighed through his nose and made a carefully considered move. Nanzo was very slightly dubious. Could Genji possibly thinking that he'd be left out of this? He couldn't even imagine what was happening inside this mansion, but he definitely couldn't deny the possibility that Kinzo had devised something. If you liken this island to chess, Kinzo had opened the game, and as a result, six pieces had been defeated. Could it be that Genji was calm because he believed he alone was on the outside of the chessboard and therefore safe? Or the culprit? Isn't everyone just a piece on the chessboard lined up equally without any exceptions?Wasn't even Genji, who had gained more of Kinzo's trust than anyone, no, who was confident of his position as Kinzo's only close friend, just another one of the pieces laid out on the chessboard?
Genji-san, 私は今夜が本当に怖いので、無事に明日の朝を迎えられることを心より願っています。
The guest room Miva and Hideyoshi moved into had originally been built to house guests before the guest house's construction. So until a few years ago, they stayed in these rooms every family conference and they were very familiar with them. This room was just like a room at a hotel with a bedroom and a bathroom. So even though they were still shut in, it was far more comfortable than the parlor.
やっぱり家族だけだとリラックスできる。他のみんなも客室にこもって鍵をかけてりゃいいんや。
夏日姉さんが客間を出るなって威張り散らしてるんだもん。誰も口答えなんてできないでしょ。あの人ずっと冷や飯を食ってきたから、兄さんが死んでやっと天下が来たって。はっ、まったくずーずーしいったらあれしない。
まあそう言うな。夏日さんもあれで結構頑張っとるんやで。お前もそう突っかからんでもいいやないか。さっきのレシートの件もあそこまでは言い過ぎやで。
だってあそこで言わなかったらもう言うタイミングがないんだもん。
Yeah, true. You did kind of go a little too far. Eva soaking cutely and looking at the... Soaking cutely? What the frick? Looking at the television set alongside Hideyoshi, who was lying on the bed.
でも、
Oh, I know what's happening.
そうやな。思えば、わしもお前も老けたもんや。ジョージが生まれてから、何もかもが。
本当にあっという子供を作るの、焦りすぎたかしら。
Eva's eyes looked like they were staring off into the distance. Yes, she had thought of it as once in a lifetime chance.Her older brother Kraus had been unable to father a child for quite some time. 6 years passed after his marriage to Natsu without any signs of pregnancy, which didn't please Kinzo at all. Eva herself had thought that. Since her name would be removed outside the Yoshima family register and she got married anyway, it didn't matter whether a successor to the head sip was born or not. And then one day, she had a heavenly revelation. Maybe it was the whisperings of the devil that she had listened to or agreed.If she could give birth to a successor first, wouldn't she be able to remain the Yoshima register? If things went well, might she have a chance to inherit the Yoshima family herself? When she proposed this to Hideyoshi, he had approved of it instantly. This was because Hideyoshi also had greedy thoughts. For Hideyoshi, who had no close relatives, it was a chance for him to feel once more like the long-forgotten thing called family. So when they got married, he hadn't fussed over which name they were kept. Ah, that makes sense. It hadn't been easy to persuade Kinzo, but as his daughter, Eva knew Kinzo's personality well, so by choosing the time when Kinzo was most dissatisfied with Natsui, she was magnificently able to make him accept Hideyoshi as an adopted son-in-law. Looking at Hideyoshi, who had achieved success after starting from nothing, Kinzo might have seen a bit of himself. He quickly grew to like Hideyoshi and approve his transfer into the Hiroshima Register. George would eventually become a successor to the Hiroshima family. They had raised him strictly with that purpose in mind. He had been with for a while, and had grown into a fabulous young man, but wouldn't disappoint no matter where he went. That's why he had not been permitted to fall in love with a servant like Sanin. So once he'd learned that Sanin was dead and the engagement was now invalid, though part of her had still been shocked by the gruesome crime, part of her also been relieved that her dear George wouldn't be stolen by some servant. That's kind of bad.
クラウス兄さんのことが昔偉そうで威張ってて 自分がやがては当主になるのだと人だから それに一矢報いてでもそれは子供の頃の感情
Oh my god, she has character development.
結局自分の人生のほとんどを支配した それだけならまだいい その感情はあなたやジョージまで巻き込んで振り回してしまった
Eva, その前自分を責めるな。
Hideyoshi got up and held Eva's shoulders, so he could feel a warm understanding from him.
わしはな、自分の人生はもうでもな、今日までの生活を後悔したことは一度もないで、一度もや。
No, stop talking about that. You're gonna be the next one to die if you talk about that.
他の男ともじゃ味わえん楽しい人生に戦争で身寄りを失ったわしに。 もう一度家族のぬくもりを教えてくれた。だから後宮の家には感謝しとるし、わしのゆいわしとお前が歩んできた人生にな。今日までほんまに楽しい人生やったで。ありがとう、あなた。
Eva hung her head, burying her face in Hideyoshi's chest. Probably no one in the park could even imagine this side of Eva existed.
わしや、今日までお前と一緒にいて後悔した日なんて。私もよ、あなたと一緒になれてよかった。ジョージももう立派な大人や。わしが見張ってなくてもしっかり仕事ができる一人前や。で、正月あたりをのんびりモルジブあたりで過ごさんか。 わしら二人水いらずや。いやよ、毎年年賀状の返礼で寝る暇もないとか言ってるじゃな。次の正月だけはなしや。年賀状はみん黙ってしたのお年玉くじだけチェックするんや。今年はカラーテレビくらい当てたいで。やだ、モルジブでお年玉くじのチェックなんてしたくない。じゃあそいつもなしや、水いらず。 のんびりで、ジョージが生まれる直前の新婚時代の続きをちょいとしてみんか。それならいいわね。モルジブはええとこらしいで、なんもない島に美しいサンゴ礁と水上コテージが並んでてな。新婚時代の続きっていつからなの？仕事納めしたらすぐや。旅行で見聞いてみんとわからんが、
Eva nagged at his lips in a peevish yet fluidous manner. The only sounds that filled the room were the distant voice of the announcer on the news, which Hideyoshi had left on, and the obnoxious pounding of the rain against the window. Oh wow, gunshot transition. There was a knock on the door and Genji-san entered.
奥様, お夕食の準備が整いました。
Dinner is ready! And I think that's also a good time to end here. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please make sure to like, subscribe, it's greatly appreciated. And yeah, I shall see you guys in the next one. Bye!